Hello, and welcome to another episode of Trails of Cold Steel. Excitingly enough, we're about to embark on another field study. Although I think I've got a practical exam, yeah. We'll see how long I've got to meet a day. Pretty beat. Smell it. It was always you, Elliot. It was always you. Let's go ahead and turn that off before it beeps at me again. Leave it like it is.
Don't you dare hold back!
Don't worry, I won't.
All right.
My turn!
S-craft, no... no items.
Arcus, activate!
My turn! Keep it up, everyone!
Here. Oh no. Don't blind me.
Go.
Oh. Fudge you.
My turn. Good night.
Target locked.
Top. My turn. Arcus, activate. Ha! Here we go.
Target locked.
My turn. Here we go.
Right.
It'd be really cool if I'm gonna fall asleep. Yes! Oh, don't wake her up.
My turn! Alright, let's do this!
Got it!
Too slow!
My turn! Keep it up, everyone!
Here!
Here we go! Go!
I'll pick you up!
I was careless.
Flames, gather on my blade!
Wasn't strong enough.
Wasn't so bad.
It's safe for now.
That. You know, it's almost more weird to not say what that was just now with those sounds. So, if you don't want to hear something gross, just stop listening for a moment. Sudden, unexpected testicular pain. Don't know where it came from, but, resolved itself. There, I said it. Hopefully nobody's too disgusted by the idea of my balls. Man, her arm just clipped straight through her titty. Ooh, we got all the troubled pairings. Oh, cool. We're all going to the same place.
This is our chance to discuss what to do before they get here. But to be honest, I don't really have any good ideas. How about you guys?
I can't say that I do. Unlike me and Eustace, at least Laura and Fie understand each other to some degree. Our group's performance in last month's field study wasn't amazing, but there were no actual conflicts or anything.
Yeah, that's all the more reason why I feel like we should step in and do something for them. But from what Elisa and Emma have told me, it seems like they have trouble connecting with each other.
Yeah, that's the impression I get, too. It's not like they hate each other. They're just having trouble coming to terms with their differences.
On the one hand, we have the daughter of a noble military family. A knight in shining armor, as it were. While on the other, we have a girl who spent her childhood on the battlefield running with Jaegers. Their upbringings couldn't be more different when you think about it. Maybe their values, too.
You're right. I wonder if that's...
I apologize for the delay.
Hey! Good morning, Laura.
My, you're certainly the early bird today.
You needn't worry about us. We have no intention of causing trouble, and we're prepared to do what we can to form a combat link as soon as possible. It's not our intention to be confrontational towards one another.
Oh, this is the worst kind of fight. Acknowledge it, damn it.
Is that not the case, Fie?
Yep. Don't worry. We won't bring the group down during the field study.
Well, if you say so.
That's not really what we're worried about.
Anyway, we should finish up our preparations and head over to the station. I'll bet Group B's waiting there for us already.
Agreed.
I want their playing courts too, not just the rare ones. Oh, I hope I don't vomit. Oh, just real quick, I gotta buy those tonics I keep thinking about. The balms or whatever they are. Why would a general goods store not have these things? I'll buy them there. I thought Juices was in our group. Well, thank God we got Elliot. All right. Let's equip everybody before I forget. Gotta open that, but apart from that, we're all good to go. I didn't equip their accessories. Oh well. It keeps going higher. It's not what I want to see.
Go easy on me, okay? Okay then, let's draw! Looks like you're up first. The same score means we draw again, right? Looks like you're up first. Mirror! The same score means we draw again, right? Well, looks like I'm up first. The same score means we draw again, right? Well, looks like I'm up first. The same score means we draw again, right? 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 Well, looks like I'm up first. I didn't see that coming. I lost.
Eat shit, Elliot. Eat my shit. I'm sorry, you're my favorite. You have the best healing.
Then let us begin our duel. Please draw a card. The first move is yours. We're evenly matched. Let's redraw. We're evenly matched. Let's redraw. The first move is yours.
Oh. Budget.
I didn't expect that. Divine Bolt! Divine Bolt! Well played. Mirror. Mirror. We're evenly matched. Let's redraw. The first move is yours. We're evenly matched. Let's redraw. We're evenly matched. Let's redraw. Then I'll make the first move. An excellent duel.
What? No, I don't. All I had to do was... God damn you. God damn you, rules of the game. If I used my mirror, I would have won.
I'm not going to hold back.
Hate the stupid card game.
Well then, go ahead and draw. We're even. We'll have to redraw. I'll go first then. Mirror! We're even. We'll have to redraw. We're even. We'll have to redraw. It looks like you're up first. Mirror! Looks like I win this time.
It's a fair win.
Let the battle begin. We draw here, right? I'm first. Take this. Take this. Crap. Crap. Guess I lost.
exactly on time.
Huh?
Wait, what?
Hear that?
You're from the Railway Military Police, if memory serves me correctly.
You're Captain Claire, was it?
That's right. I'm glad you remember me. I believe it's been about 3 months since we last met.
So, this must be the woman the group who went to Keldic encountered.
So this is an officer from the fearsome RMP?
Since you're here, does that mean you're going to be the one assigning our tasks for this month's field study?
No, I'm just here to provide a place for you to talk with the person who is. He should be here any moment now. Oh, here he comes.
Perfect timing.
Oh shit, Machias is dead.
No way.
Dad?
Huh.
I've seen him in the Imperial Chronicle before.
Governor Regnitz, one of the reformists' most influential voices.
So this is Machias' father.
This is the first time I've met most of you, so let me introduce myself. I'm Carl Regnitz, Machias' father. I'm the governor of Heimdall and head of the local government. It's a pleasure to finally meet you, ladies and gentlemen of Class 7.
So, everyone has a relation on the board of directors, it seems like. What does that book in the background say? Christ, who's gonna die first? Oh, I like it. My money's on Gaius. Elliot's kind of a close second, though. I'm vaguely uncomfortable with how close some of these family relationships are, and how often they lean into, like, romantic stuff. Yeah, I'm just gonna say the word incest. A little uncomfortable. Thank you. Ooh. That's Machias' dad with a different hair color. I know there's a limit to the number of models you can really stick in your average game, but that's a little too blatant. You know, for me. Hey, there we go. Getting back down. Fuck me, I didn't want to do that. Oh well. Kind of store. Not as cool as I was expecting. I wonder if I shouldn't just start selling these things. But also, I just don't wanna. Equipped. Go play game. Yeah.
Isn't this...
Oh, this is where they published the Imperial Chronicle newspaper.
Hey, last month's photographer. I'll have to come back for that. Bookstore with Monkey as his fake dad. I dig the layout. Oh, that's a nice service. So interesting. Very cool to have a place to do that. Almost certainly a reference to something. Kind of cool. Hats off. Reichel's Plaza.
Here's the statue of Emperor Dreikles. He strikes quite a stately pose.
Weird to think he's the one who founded our academy.
Doesn't look right.
Looks like we've hit a dead end.
This area seems easy to get lost in.
Uh-oh. Oh, cool.
Thank you.
Oh my.
Lady Clotilde, is it time for you to depart?
Yes, I'll be stepping out for a while. But more importantly, who do we have here?
Is that... No way!
Vita Clotilde?
Whoa! I can't believe it! It's really her!
I never thought I'd actually get the chance to meet her.
Wait, who is this now?
You three! Don't just stand there staring! You're in the presence of the legendary opera singer Vita Clotilde! The Azure Diva herself!
The Azure Diva, huh? I do recall hearing that name at some point.
Wait, you know who she is?
I'm not surprised. Opera is a world unto itself. I expect there are multitudes who have never heard of me before. I'm Vita Clotilde, an opera singer. I'd be delighted if you would come and hear me sing sometime.
Oh, what a nice-looking treasure chest.
Now's our chance! We can do this!
My turn!
I'll handle it. Target locked!
My turn.
Right.
Go! There! Okay, it's safe for now.
Oh, a treasure chest!
Now's our chance. Let's go! Now's our chance!
You're open.
Okay. Target locked!
Of course! We should keep going. Not bad.
All right!
An A-plus outcome.
Ooh, very nice.
I spy treasure. Eliminated. Let's get going.
I did it!
Oh, cool. Didn't really need more of those, but I'll take them. God damn, will I take them.
Advantage is ours. Let's finish him.
Here we go! Second form! Damn! Go!
You're open.
Okay. Here!
My turn!
Target's eliminated. Let's get going. Done.
Oh, what a nice looking treasure chest.
Hut.
My turn! We'll cut our own path!
This would make a great training area. I envy the people who live around here.
Only you would see an underground passage and think about training.
Now's our chance! We can do this!
My turn!
Okay. Target locked.
My turn.
My turn. Good night.
My turn. Target locked.
Here we go!
Ha! My turn!
Of course! Ha! We should keep going.
Second form, Gale! Go!
Broken.
I'll handle it. Here!
Right!
My turn. Target's eliminated. Let's get going.
Oh, a treasure chest!
Now's our chance. Let's get him! Go! The second form, Gale! Now's our chance!
Broken.
Okay. Target locked!
Of course!
Is everybody okay?
Oh, very cool.
Bring it on!
Ooh, so many.
My turn! All right, let's do this!
Understood.
Got it!
My turn. Off guard. Elliot!
Got it!
My turn. Eliminated. Let's get going.
I've only just begun.
Done.
I did it!
I did it!
Now's our chance. We can...
Here we go! Second form! Gale! Go!
We're open.
Okay. Here we go. Yeah. Now.
Go!
My turn!
Advantage is ours. Let's finish him.
My turn.
Second form, Gale! Now's our chance!
Broken.
My turn. Here I go.
My turn! Ignite!
Of course!
Okay. Hostiles neutralized. Guess we're safe.
Great!
That's a lot of them at once.
Ha! Now's our chance. Let's get them. My turn. The second form. Gale! Now's our chance.
Broken.
I'll handle it. Got it.
Got it.
My turn. Ta! We should keep going.
Ta! Ha! Ta! Ha!
The advantage is ours.
Okay. Here we go.
My turn.
My turn.
Right. Ta! You still have a lot of training to do. The advantage is ours.
Here we go. Second form, Gale! Now's our chance!
Broken.
I'll handle it. Here we go.
Right. All right, let's keep going.
Turn. The second form, Gale!
My turn. Here I go.
Right. Shatter!
My turn. Is everybody okay?
Success.
Yeah.
Now's our chance. Let's get him! My turn! The second form! Gale! Go!
Broken.
I'll handle it. Here I go.
Right!
Of course! Hey! Evil will fall before my blade!
Now's our chance! We can do this!
Here we go! The second form! Gale! Go! Fie!
Okay.
Is everybody okay?
Oh, that thing is rather large.
Dangerous.
Let's do this!
Got it!
Okay. Here we go. Now!
An opening!
My turn! Give it up, everyone!
Go.
My turn! Second form! Gale! Now's our chance!
I'll take you up!
Oh.
My turn.
Beep.
Target locked.
My turn. Analyzing enemy attack patterns. Analysis complete!
Right! Shatter!
Here we go! Second form, Gale! Go! Elliot!
Okay!
My turn. Target locked.
Right.
Oh, I've got 0 rewards.
Here we go! All right, let's do this!
Got it!
Got me!
Right! Now!
Got it!
My turn! Shatter!
My turn! Now's our chance!
I'll take you up! Right!
My turn! Here we go.
Flames, gather on my blade.
We should keep going.
Shit.
I did it!
Not bad.
Ooh. I think that's my first class S.
I did it!
An A-plus outcome. Well, That was... You know, maybe you should just stop worrying about trying to form a combat link with each other.
Yeah, maybe. I mean, I can see why you'd really want to.
No. I don't want to hold our group back more than I already have. I'd like to withdraw from active combat and take a more supporting role for the duration of this field study.
Huh? Why?
But Laura, it doesn't make any sense for you not to be in the thick of the fight.
Don't be ridiculous. If anyone should be benched, it's me. It makes sense when you consider what each of us brings to a fight.
No. My own immaturity is the cause of this. There's still a part of me that refuses to accept you, and this is the result. I'm sorry. I didn't think I was this narrow-minded. And I apologize for the distress my prejudice has no doubt been causing you. I came to realize during my club activities that I still have a lot of maturing left to do.
Laura.
As such, Reen, I wish to withdraw.
Denied. Actually, I'll be the one withdrawing from frontline combat.
What? Huh?
Reen?
This seems awfully sudden. What's your line of thinking?
During all the battles we fought, one thing stood out to me. I couldn't help but notice that under ordinary circumstances, Laura and Fee's fighting styles complement each other perfectly.
I...
Well...
You think so?
Interesting. What do you mean?
Laura's the ideal knight, standing strong in the thick of the fight, dominating enemies with her blade. Then there's Fie, the ideal vanguard, overwhelming the opposition with their speed and creating openings for Laura. During the practical exam, none of us should have stood a chance against the two of you.
When you put it that way, it does make sense.
If they could form a combat link, they'd be virtually unstoppable.
Yeah. I don't think that's escaped you two either. That's why you keep trying to form a combat link, but there's something stopping you from connecting with each other. Whatever it is, it's been frustrating both of you this whole time, right?
Mm-hmm. It's exactly as you say.
Okay, so, since that's how things stand, it makes no sense for you two to just give up and withdraw from combat. In fact, considering everyone's relative strengths and weaknesses, it makes the most sense for me to fall back. This way, you'll have more chances to work out whatever it is that's standing in the way of you forming a link.
You have my thanks.
We'll take you up on your offer, then.
That's what I like to hear.
You really can be audacious sometimes, you know. Just like you were with me and Eustace.
You think? I don't really think I did anything out of the ordinary.
That's so you, Reen, to not think anything of it.
Oh, that's so Reen.
Still, thanks to you, there might be hope for these two after all.
We'll do what we can.
But first, we need to get back to the hotel, right?
I'm feeling better and it's going down. That's good. Don't think I actually need to rest, but I'm gonna. Just you try and fucking stop me. Please don't try to stop me.
Uh-oh. Boss monster incoming. Maybe we should push the giant brick. Okay, I just have to get them, period, with her. I shouldn't say period like that. I just have to hit them at all.
Right! Locked and loaded! You won't get away!
I'll handle it. We can't relax yet. Done. Beginning combat.
Right.
Leave it to me.
Okay. There's a light.
The sound's getting louder too.
Hey!
You must be getting close to the exit now.
Finishing. Okay. Here I go. Now. Come on, Mafia.
Leave it to me. Take this.
My turn. Good night.
Ah!
right!
I'll handle it. Hostiles neutralized. Guess we're safe.
Oh, what a nice looking treasure chest.
Not too shabby.
Whoa, this is incredible.
You could open a shop with all the instruments here.
A piano, violins, wind instruments, a robust percussion section. I'm assuming the papers in the cabinet are all sheet music.
There's no way you can call this just a hobby.
Yeah, coming in here, this must look like some rabid obsession to you guys. You know, my mom was a pretty famous pianist. Being raised around music like that, my sister and I ended up sharing her love of music.
Really?
Looking at all this, I can see why you decided to join the wind orchestra at the academy.
Still, why didn't you go to the same school as the people we met earlier?
Fie?
Wait, Fie, that's not...
Don't worry about it. I'm sure this comes as no surprise. But I'd originally planned to attend the music academy.
Oh.
My sister and I grew up listening to our mom play the piano. Dad was more the strong, stoic type. He didn't know much about music, but he was head over heels in love with her. Our home was always filled with the sound of music, and it kept our family smiling together. But 7 years ago, Mom got really ill. Eventually, she passed away. After her death, my sister and I both wanted to follow in her footsteps. She enrolled at the music academy and began working toward a career as a pianist. Naturally, I tried to do the same, but Dad wouldn't hear of it. It's one thing to have it as a hobby, but the idea of a man of the Empire making his living through music is absurd. No matter how hard I tried to convince him, he just shook his head and refused to listen. Then he started recommending one military academy after another, trying to push me toward a career in the army. Eventually, I didn't have much choice. I had to give up my dream of attending the music academy. I hated him for it. I really did. I'm no good at fighting, never have been. I'd get smoked in a real war. But after some research, I found one academy, Thor's, offered plenty of music-related classes, and that about half of its graduates end up in careers outside the military. In the end, I met him halfway and chose to enroll at Thor's. Kinda pathetic, huh? You've all got great reasons why you're there at the academy. Then there's me, who'd rather be on a stage than a battlefield, but I couldn't go against my dad. For a while, I started to think that maybe my passion for music had kind of cooled off. But I'm still full of regrets about the music academy and the summer festival concert, so I guess it hasn't after all. Oh, I wish I could just crawl into a hole right now.
So that's how you ended up at Thor's.
I had no idea.
Do you regret it? Coming to Thor's and all?
Huh? Of course not. Why would I?
Huh?
So you don't?
Life at the academy keeps me busy, but I still have time to perform with the wind orchestra after class is out. And I feel like I really broaden my horizons every time we go on a field study. Honestly, I feel like I get more out of Thor's than if I had just enrolled at the music academy without much thought. Maybe it's because whether I decide I want to be a musician or do something else totally different, I'll at least have the chance to choose what I want without someone deciding for me.
Elliot.
Wow, you've really given this a lot of thought.
You really are strong, Elliot.
I wish I thought so too. I still feel jealous when I see my friends who went to the music academy putting their heart and soul into their music. But even with that, I've got no regrets about coming to Thor's. None at all. Besides, if I hadn't come, I never would have met you guys, would I? I'd regret that way more.
How can you say that with a straight face?
Maybe he's just oblivious.
I didn't think I was saying anything particularly embarrassing.
I'd figured that most people would blush saying something like that.
God, how much have I fucked up the audio this whole episode, I just realized. Hopefully it's not too echoey.
Still, this is Elliot we're talking about. He can get away with it.
You're the last person who should be saying that, Reen. Actually, I just remembered. I guess I do have one regret after all.
Oh?
What is it?
Remember the summer festival concert my friends said they're going to be performing in? Back when my mom was still alive, she performed in it, and my sister played in it 5 years ago, too. So I was really hoping that I'd be able to take the stage there one day, too.
Ah, what a pleasant evening.
It's pretty relaxing.
No denying those two have some surprising similarities.
I don't see any people in this part of the park.
I'm fine with here if you are.
All right, Fie. Here are my conditions. If I win this duel, I want you to tell me about your past, your personal history. At first, there was something about your strength that I couldn't bring myself to accept. From the moment we first met, I could tell you were holding back, and considering your build, your combat proficiency is extraordinary. It's simply too far removed from what I've come to know through following the way of the sword.
No doubt.
Really?
Yeah, all things considered, Fie's strength is totally improbable for someone her size.
To add to that, you were once part of a Jaeger Corps. I can't say I've ever thought of the Jaegers in a particularly favorable light. If one defines knighthood as the way of the virtuous, how can the path of the Jaeger be seen as anything but corrupt? I came to believe that because we'd been raised with such strongly opposing values, I could not accept you.
Damn it, don't go back up.
However, I was mistaken. After hearing Elliot's story, I asked myself again why it was that I felt such resistance to fighting alongside you. I tried to ascertain my own feelings, slowly and carefully. And that was when I finally realized. During all these months we spent together, I've known deep down that you were worthy of my trust. Our values had nothing to do with that judgment. It came from my heart alone. But in my stubbornness, I refused to acknowledge that one simple truth. In my heart, I had already deemed you worthy of trust. Yet in my mind, I still couldn't see past our incompatibilities. I suspect that contradiction was what prevented us from using our Arcus to fight as one.
So, that's how it was. Did you know about this?
Yeah, I noticed during our fight with that monster earlier.
You aren't the only one who thought we couldn't get along. You live your life so honestly. I guess somewhere along the way I'd given up on you ever accepting me.
I see.
Still. What does this have to do with wanting to know about my past? Why do you want to know?
It's very simple, really. I want to know because I like you.
What are you...
I find it frustrating when I'm not able to understand those I've taken an interest in or have a high opinion of. I felt like this several months ago with Reen, and I feel the same way now. That's why I want to know your history. I want to know what shaped you into who you are now. That said, this is simply an act of self-indulgence on my part. Nothing more, nothing less.
I'm not sure what to say.
That's our lore, all right.
You really are something else. It's fine. I don't mind telling you. But taking your spoils by force is the Jaeger's way through and through. Is that okay with you?
It's fine. Because I have no intention of thinking of my reward as a spoil of battle. I'd much rather consider it an honor, bestowed for a hard-won victory.
Fine by me.
You just talk things out. Why do you even need to fight now?
All right. I'll officiate your duel. Neither of you need to hold anything back. If I
Very well.
No. Oh.
Thanks.
Damn it.
Go!
Impressive.
Same to you.
Then I won't hold back. Allow me to show my strongest skill learned from my father.
Then I'll show you my strongest. Learned it from the boss himself.
That's enough!
I couldn't even tell who won.
What about you, Reen?
I feel bad saying this after volunteering to be the judge, but as far as I could tell, it was a draw.
Really?
Huh. Well, I suppose it is what it is. I'll simply have to continue my training and challenge you again another time. And don't forget, I still wish to duel you as well.
Wait, why me?
Honestly.
Actually, I lost this one.
Huh?
Jaegers are at our best when we fight at night. The darkness gives us an edge. But even after I threw out a flash grenade, the duel still ended in a draw. If we'd fought during the day, I would have lost.
That's...
She has a point.
Well then.
Very well. I'll accept this victory.
Well, anyway,
I guess the two of us should go for a little stroll then.
I don't mind if you listen. Is that fine with you, Laura?
I have no objections. We're all in this together.
Okay. I used to be part of a Jaeger Corps called Zephyr. Before that, my earliest memories are of explosions and battlefields. I found myself wandering in a war-torn hotspot on the outskirts of some country I never even knew the name of. Jaeger Corps threw themselves into battle for the highest bidder day after day, while I wandered alone. The man who eventually took me in called himself the Jaeger King. He was the leader of Zephyr, a pretty famous Jaeger Corps. He was middle-aged, crafty, stubborn, and lucky. He always seemed so carefree, but he never let his guard down. To me, though, he was the closest thing to a father I've ever had. The other members of Zephyr had their quirks, but they were all nice to me. As time went on, I started helping with the cleaning, the cooking, the packing. During my free time, they started teaching me all kinds of skills I'd need to survive on the battlefield. One thing led to another, and I ended up fighting in my first real battle. I was 10, I think. The boss was reluctant, but after the others persuaded him, he made me a full-fledged member of the group. For the next few years, we lived and fought together. I even picked up a nickname like some career Jaegers do. Sylphied. We roamed all across the continent together. There were hard times. Times when we thought we might not live through the night, but we always did. Together. Until last year, when our boss died. It was a clash with another Jaeger Corps, the Red Constellation. People used to say they were the only other Jaeger Corps in West Zemuria who could match us. Their leader, a guy they called the War God, had been on bad terms with our boss for years. Eventually, the War God and the Jaeger King decided to settle things with one big duel. They kept going for 3 days and 3 nights. In the end, they both fell. After that, the Zephyr I'd grown up with disbanded. All the members who were left just kind of scattered. I don't know where they went. Then, just like that, I was alone again.
I don't know what to say.
After that, you ended up coming to the academy?
Yep. Just when I was wondering what I'd do next, Sarah showed up. She said she'd been following the situation between Zephyr and the Red Constellation. That's how we first met. I told her about what happened, and she dragged me to the academy. She introduced me to the principal, and after that, well, you know the rest.
That's quite a history. Listening to you tell your story really brings into focus how limited my view of the world has been. But I feel like I finally know you. There's still so much more I want to learn, of course, but At least this gives me a base to build on. How about it? Care to mix things up a little?
Oh. Let's do it.
Now wait just a minute.
I should have known. I guess I've had this coming since the practical exam, huh?
Well, it's at your discretion, of course. I doubt either of us has the energy to fight at our peak.
But we'll give it a try.
You've got to be kidding me! We haven't got a chance against them!
Come on, this is a good opportunity to see what they can really do, right? Let's just think of this as a little bonus for our field study and give it the best we've got.
Fine. But I don't intend to hold back, so I expect no less from both of you.
You have my thanks.
Here we go.
I'm not going to hold back.
Fine, I'll do it. Hang in there, everyone!
Thanks! Alright, let's do this!
Alright!
Okay. Here I go.
Should have seen that coming.
Of course.
Shatter!
My turn. Here I go.
This is so ridiculous.
Hostiles neutralized. Guess we're safe.
We did it.
Uh-huh.
You too. It's like they're off in their own little world.
I think we've just witnessed the birth of an unstoppable duo.
Hey, what are you four doing?
Oh, crap.
Uh-oh.
Students, are you from one of the local high schools?
We received reports of a group causing a terrible racket in the park. What in Adios's name were you doing?
Please, sir, this isn't what it might seem like. There's a perfectly reasonable, though admittedly rather complicated explanation for all of this.
We're very sorry for any trouble we've caused. We tried to minimize the disturbance to others, but it seems we weren't totally successful there.
Perhaps dueling in the park wasn't as good of an idea as it first seemed.
Maybe the underground tunnels would have been better.
You know, it's a little late for such deep insights. Besides, who do you think were the ones who started this? Don't just act like you're some innocent bystanders.
Ooh, you're moving up in the world. I've got a little reward here for you. Drinks are on me someday.
Huh? Are they all still asleep? It's almost time for breakfast.
Oh, it's you, Elliot. Sorry, we didn't mean to keep you waiting.
What's wrong? You look exhausted.
You might say we had a pretty eventful night.
Look at these geriatrics. On the other hand, as you can see, we have gusto to spare. Isn't that right, Fie?
And you call yourselves men.
How can you two just waltz around like that after last night? Are you even human?
Oh, just calm down.
Wow,
what the the heck did you guys do last night? The two of you look like you've been chased around town by wolves, but Fie and Laura are all buddy-buddy now.
Yeah, we'll catch you up on that later. First things first, let's grab the list of today's tasks from the mailbox.
Old Man Keaton. Why is that familiar? Gonna take this opportunity to get to bed. Gotta get up early and grab myself a COVID test tomorrow. Well, it's been fun. If you caught me live, thanks for catching me live. If you caught me on YouTube, I appreciate you watching the VOD. Have a good one. Goodbye.